New South Wales, tonight weighing in at 76 kilograms. He is trained by Lee Carr and Angelo Haider, with a record of 47 fights, 42 wins, 28 knockouts. He is Shannan the Bull Blaster Taylor.
Shannan Taylor, very much the game face on. Brian McMahon is your referee for the contest. There is our visitor, arrived in Australia only today, Sergio Acuna. Let's hope he was able to get just a couple of hours sleep on the bird as we go centering for the instructions.
Okay, this is the back of the neck. When I say break, you step back, don't hit on the break. Shake it, wait for the bell. You're shaking. Shake it into you. Good luck.
Here we go. 10 rounds. At junior middleweight, it was the catch anyway. Shannan Taylor in the black. So too. Opponent here tonight, a great crowd in attendance. We hope you've enjoyed the July edition of Big Time Boxing. It is main event time.
Well, that's the big thing here, Andy. You know, Shannan was about 15 pounds overweight before they fought the last time, 2 days out. Yesterday, he was right on target. I spent about 2 hours with him, going over fight films with him, and just watch the way his body is ripped. You people will be able to see that for yourself. And Acuna is going to feel his power to the body, because that's where Shannan wants to rough him up early. You see, right away he goes for those hooks.
In fact, the massive weight differential in Shannan Taylor, Ray, from yesterday when he weighed in, back to today, he knew that Acuna was slightly over the weight, and Shannan has put on, well, a lot more weight in 24 hours than perhaps you normally would.
Well, yesterday, Andy weighed in at 69.7, and today he weighed in at 76 kilos, so he's put on 7 kilos.
Wow, following my diet.
Damn it. Andy, don't you worry about it. Take a look at me.
Here they are, Acuna and Taylor, opening minute, round number one.
I like the patience I'm seeing from Shannan. He's not rushing himself. He's taking his time. He'll set up his shot. There he goes with the right hand lead. And again, those rips to the body there. You call them rips. We call them hooks in the States. But he really has that down. And he knows how to finish when he gets a guy in trouble.
Any man that steps center ring has certainly got my respect and the respect of any genuine boxing fan. But you can see that Acuna has been out of the ring for some time. Doesn't look in the shape that he did last time he was here, and Shannan Taylor is going to try and expose that weakness. Taylor is great at going to the body and sustaining an attack there. Don't be surprised if that is exactly what transpires over the next couple of rounds. Against the ropes, Taylor again searching down low.
Yeah, he's really filling him out now, Andy. And Ray, yeah, you know this as good as anybody. Nobody throws a better left hook to the body than this kid does when he doubles and triples with it.
That's his best punch, Colonel. It certainly damages his opponents every time he lands that, and then he breaks him in two with it.
Acuna's slick, though, the way he gets his right elbow down to prevent it. And he throws it back pretty good because he's letting it fly here, I'd say, in the first two or three rounds, because I don't know how the guy can possibly recover from that long, long trip. So he's going to let it go. I mean, he's a battler. He's a bull. He's a three, though.
Bobby certainly does have to let it go. And also, I guess the question mark is, on such late notice, taking in consideration the flight, just how many rounds can Sergio Acuna match it physically with Shannan Taylor?
Well, he just took a vicious left hook to the body right in the area of the liver, and he's not going to be able to take much more of that punishment. I mean, we got 26 seconds to go on this round, and he's already ripped him about 6 or 7 times. Hard shot to the body.
Acuna has certainly felt the power of Taylor. Acuna's got a good shot on him, too. When fully fit, tonight is not that night. 10 seconds remain. Round number one. It has been a Taylor and Acuna really very much on the front foot. He has unfinished business here, Sergio Acuna. Bell sounds. 3 minutes down. It was Taylor's round, mate. No mistake about it.
You know, in a way, this is the way Tyson should have fought McBride when they fought. You know, the way that Acuna come in here, play that three-round fight and forget it. Do the best you can and let it fly.
Bend down for the ribbon, just finish on top. That's all you have to do. Catch him all the night.
prepare to go into round number two. Electing to stand between rounds is Sergio Acuna. Perhaps after such a long flight, he just doesn't want to get settled over there in the red corner. It could be Mission Impossible getting him out.
And he doesn't want to sit out again. He's been sitting down for a while already.
It's going to be 30 hours from Buenos Aires.
Brutal.
Okay, round number two here at the Evan Theatre, the main event of the July edition in big time boxing. Great bringing you two live shows in 7 days. And don't forget Danny Green live on Main Event Channel, Fox Sports, Pumps and Clubs this coming Sunday. Please check your guides, a card well worth looking at, headlined by the Green Machine. Our focus at the moment is the Bulleye Blaster, Shannan Taylor.
I expect to see Shannan pick up the pace here a little bit more now. He's had his feeling out on the right hand lead.
Wow! He is unloading Taylor. Acuna is not going to be able to take too much more of this.
Hold on the head and cut it off.
Acuna, though, is riding very much on emotion. Taylor riding on power, on finesse. For the visitor, it is very much emotion. He believes there is unfinished business and searching a little low.
Bend the front legs. Come on.
In against the ropes, and Shannan nicely turning his opponent there, not showing too much caution.
Nah, gee, it was just Acuna just pity patting to the stomach, and Shannan wants no part of that. He just flips him around. That's like a great turn job by Shannan. They get himself back set again. Watch the right hand power come now. He knows he can nail him with the left hand.
Acuna's really throwing his punches wisely, an economy of punches, if you will. He quite simply knows he doesn't have too many he is able to throw. A weary person. Down low, looking to go up high with the right hand. Taylor very well aware of exactly what Sergio was trying there and stalking his opponent back into the blue corner. Acuna almost blown to the ground.
Well, you know, that's a sign of weakness, too. I mean, Ray, you know, if a guy's tying his legs a week, you can push him down easily. That's an indication of what we're seeing here. This guy's very fatigued.
He's tried, Colonel, that all those hours in the airplane is exactly slowing him up.
That's the second time that Sergio has complained about a low shot in this second round. Taylor again apologises, but as Bob pointed out, this was a point of contention the first time these two met on September 24 of last year.
Shannan does such a great job with those body shots, but he doesn't need to be that low. But why he's going low is because Acuna covers himself up with his right elbow. So he's trying to get, he needs to get behind it instead of below it, because McMahon will take a point away next time. At least by the rules, he should take a point away if he won him twice.
And nothing silly from Shannan Taylor. Doesn't need to be conservative, but can afford to be cautious.
Oh. I like what I'm seeing in Shannan staying under control in this fight, though, now, Andy.
Bob, I can ride the clock back some 8 or 9 years ago, and Shannan Taylor and control, those two words didn't belong in the same sentence. This young man is the original wild child, and as he has matured as a person, he has matured as a boxer, and yet we're seeing a little bit more control from the blaster.
It's one of the very reasons why I've really become such a strong supporter of Shannan Taylor, because we all know about his great problems after the disappointing loss he had, and we all know that he turned his life around. He's training with the B power now, and he's training with the pain away, the only type of drugs that he's using anymore. Stuff to make himself fit and stay strong, and that's good. And when I see a kid turn his life around, I can't help but support him. I love Taylor, I really do.
100% with you there, and you can see Shannan Taylor's enthusiasm and the urgency. He's up, off the stool. The seconds are down, the seconds are out, well before time was called. There's the whistle. Taylor wants to continue on with this.
And that's more than the corner of Lee Carr and Angelo Hyde to say, you don't have to intimidate this guy. Let him know you're not tired at all, because this guy is really sucking wind right now. I mean, he's got to be totally physically exhausted.
Ray Wheatley has got a 2018, if you could argue, Ray.
No, I think that at the stage, Shannan's in complete control. And it's only a matter of time, as the Colonel said, when this guy's going to go down, I think.
Ray, watch him when he goes back on his heels. You see he's almost stumbling around, Andy. See his foot slipping. All exhaustion.
It's not a case of if anymore. It is a case of when. Here we go.
keep the clock going.
The clock is going.
Don't hit him low anymore, Shannan. Steps in. Hit him with your right
hand. One more. Take a point off. No more. That's your last chance.
Shannan, load up three right hands. Hit him with three right hands. Hit him. Three right hands in a row.
There we go. Colonel Bob lending some advice to Shannan Taylor, standing over our commentary position. I think even Sergio knows that whilst they are creeping down there, there is no intent on any of them, and that could really be the beginning of the end for Sergio Acuna. Taylor is going to really put his focus into landing upstairs. He does not need the risk of searching down low again. Acuna fighting back.
He's as tough as nails, isn't he? Man, he's got courage. That's why I love prize fighters.
That was the most impressive aspect of Sergio Acuna last time he was here at Penrith, Bob, was the fact he came to fight.
Yeah.
And it didn't matter who, it didn't matter where, he just wanted to get it on.
And he's come to fight too, but the body, I mean, see, there he is again. And that's probably the weakness. Stay with the right hand, Shannan! I can't help coaching, Andy.
1 minute left in round number three. Again, a touch of the gloves, good sportsmanship. Acuna again on the back foot. He has spent the majority of the contest back against the ropes.
Stop that footing off.
And objections from the red corner, Alberto Zaccaria and Felix Passo over there. Shannan turned to the commentary position as if to say, what?
In that case, I think he was right. I mean, he hit him with the right hand, didn't he?
Certainly appeared to from my vantage point. Acuna looking for the big roundhouse. That's not going to fool Taylor, who tonight is in his 48th bout as a professional. Man of that experience isn't going to be caught out with that big bolo punch. 18 seconds remain. Round number three. Two Taylor rounds. He has dominated. We expected him to. That is no surprise. Acuna, the legs look weary. They look rubbery. Taylor looking for that one big shot, one big combination, and it'll be time to go to the bar. Sergio almost seemed happy that he had completed three rounds. Just maybe he'll take a seat. No, he won't. He's up keeping the legs active, keeping the heart pumping and the blood going. Shannan Taylor's corner, one more control.
Bang the right hand, move, bang over the top of the right hand. Easy. Stay with it, in first. Stand. Good. It's hard to use the punches, just use your first bit more, that's all you're going to do.
Again up early is Shannan Taylor as we come out for round number four, three successive. 10-9 rounds in favour of Shannan Taylor. And there is, I guess, the only controversy of this contest, and the only thing that even remotely looks like challenging Shannan Taylor is his observation of the rules and keeping them above the belt.